Hello everyone, I am Dr. Janita Walpita from the Instrument Center. As the director of the Instrument Center, it's a pleasure for me to welcome you all to the Faculty of Applied Sciences, University of Sri Jayawardenepura. Let me brief on what the Instrument Center is. So far you have gone through several academic departments, right? However, the Instrument Center is not an academic department. It's a central research services facility governed by the Office of the Dean, and the instruments attached to the center are supervised by a set of professional academic staff members. Elaborating more on the Instrument Center, it's a central research services facility with an extensive collection of analytical instruments, and those instruments are available for the use of all researchers in the USGA community. Let me tell you how you will be using the Instrument Center. As an undergraduate student, you will be using the Instrument Center during your practical classes to analyze your samples. And also, during your final year research, you will be using the Instrument Center. Further, if you are going to do a postgraduate degree, you will be using the Instrument Center for your sample analysis. The vision of the Instrument Center is to be the center of excellence in providing high-end analytical instrumental services. And the mission statement is to be the preferred partner in academic and industrial research by providing accurate and reliable test results by maintaining high standards. While presenting all the objectives of the Instrument Center, I would emphasize two objectives that are directly related to you as undergraduate students. We make maximum availability of instrumental facilities to scholars to carry out analytical measurements for their research. And we train undergraduate students, graduate students, and the technicians for the operation of analytical instruments. These are the available instruments at the Instrument Center. All these instruments are high-tech instruments, which are very worth for several million rupees. And you will be learning about these instruments in future. We have GCMS, gas chromatography mass spectrometry. We have an XRD, X-ray diffractometry. We have AAS, atomic absorption spectrophotometer. We do have a fluorescence spectrophotometer. We have a FTIR spectrophotometer. And we have a TGA, thermogravimetry analyzer. Other than those, we have IC, ion chromatograph. And we have an UV visible spectrophotometer, UVVIS, and we have an ultra pure water purification system. Here comes the staff at the Instrument Center. I myself is a senior lecturer attached to the Instrument Center, and I am the director of the Instrument Center currently. And I am the lecturer in charge of the FTIR instrument and the fluorescence instrument. We have Dr. Dakshika Vanyarachchi as a senior lecturer, and she is the lecturer in charge for the GCMS instrument. We have Dr. Anushka Rajapaksha, a senior lecturer attached to the Instrument Center, and she is the lecturer in charge for the UV visible spectrophotometer. And Dr. Saranga Diyabalanage is the senior lecturer attached to the Instrument Center, and he is in charge of the TGA instrument. Other than those academic members, we do have some other academic members who are not directly attached to the Instrument Center yet helping us immensely on the Instrument Center functions. That's Professor Netika Vithanage. She is the director of the ERRC, Ecosphere Resilience Research Center. And we have Dr. Asita Kure, a senior lecturer attached to the Department of Chemistry. And he is in charge of the AAS, atomic absorption spectrophotometer, and IC instrument, and he was the previous director of the Instrument Center. We have Dr. Tusita Attampawala, a senior lecturer attached to the Polymer Science Department, and he is the lecturer in charge of the XRD instrument. And we do have Dr. Imalka Munavira. She is a senior lecturer at the Department of Chemistry, and she is also helping us in the functions of the Instrument Center. Other than those permanent academic staff members, we have two demonstrators, Ms. Randi Dilani and Ms. Onali Mapalagama. And we have two non-academic staff members, Mr. Sumit Priyadarshana as the technical officer and Mr. D.P. Rupasinghe as the lab attendant. Let's look at what time you will be using the instrument center. Let's say you are doing chemistry as a subject. If you look at a zoomed in version of your prospectus that you will be getting in near future, you will be doing chemistry practicals in your first year and your second year and in your third year. So it's CHE 10720, 20920 and 31520. During these practical classes, you may need to use the instrument center for your sample analysis. Going further, if you are going to get selected for an honors degree program in chemistry, you will be doing inorganic chemistry practicals in the third year, organic practicals and physical practicals in the third year as CHE 374, 375, 376, like 20 course units. During these times, you will be using the instrument center quite frequently for the sample analysis. And more importantly, during your final year, you will be doing a research project. During that time, you will be using the instrument center very often. Another example is, if you are a student at the Food Science and Technology Department, you will be doing chemistry practicals during your first year and also in the second year. So you will be using the instrument center for the sample analysis during those times. And in your final year research project, you will be again using the instrument center to do your analysis. Another example, if you are a student at the Forestry and Environmental Science Department, for your final year research project, you may need to use the instrument center as well. So after your undergraduate, if you are trying to pursue your postgraduate degree, let's say you are going to do an MPhil degree, or you are going to do an MSc, or maybe you are going to pursue a PhD. So if you are going to do it here at USJ, you may need to access the instrument center. So how you will be using the instrument center? Basically, if you are using it while you are in a practical class, while you are an undergraduate student, your lab instructor or your demonstrator will arrange it for you. You just have to follow the directions. But if you are using it as a researcher in your final year research project or as a postgraduate student, so in that case, you have to talk with your supervisor, get his or her consent, and discuss with the staff members at the instrument center. Then only you can use the instrument center. What other services we do provide? We analyze samples receiving from other academic and research institutes and also from industries. And we do carry out potential industrial research with industrial collaborations. And also we conduct short-term courses, workshops to educate the technical officers, students and relevant other people on various instrumental techniques. These are some of those examples. This is a course unit that we offer to the faculty as a faculty optional course unit, COP30310, Basic Analytical Instrumentation. And also we provide some certificate course units and also some advanced certificate courses. If you have any questions, I would recommend you to look at our website given here. And also, if you have any specific questions, feel free to email us using these email addresses. Thank you very much, and we wish you all the very best during your undergraduate career at USJ. Thank you.